garments actually the biggest industrial sector in Bangladesh, and this is the main important sector also. There are 5,000 factories in Bangladesh on which more than 4 million workers are working, and this is, in one way, this is the biggest industrial sector. In other way, this is actually the major, highest foreign money earner of the country. This sector actually covering 81% of our total export. So, very much important for the women, especially for the women empowerment, women freedom, because this is the only sector that providing more than 3 million women, those once upon a time were in the rural area and low educated, and these women were one kind of burden for the family. But now these workers, they are actually women workers, they are actually working in the garment sector, they are earning some money, they have their freedom, they are choosing their life. So this is really very much important, especially for the women workers in Bangladesh, women development in Bangladesh. Though this is the biggest and highest foreign money earner of the country, but up to now, the condition of the workers actually not very good. Though it is day by day, some progress is happening, still the minimum wage is 53 euro in a month, and for the skilled worker, 68 euro in a month. And many of the cases, still the workers, they are actually not getting the free exercise of their organizing. So there are some major challenge. One is we actually need to ensure the safe workplace for the whole workers. So Tazreen and Rana Plaza, from this disaster and the fact of building collapse, it is everybody that Bangladeshi garment workers actually need to ensure the safe workplace. From this point of view, we, the National Garment Workers Federation, we actually started some process with other affiliates of industry work, how we can make this happen. So finally, there is the agreement between companies and, on the other hand, trade union, local trade union and global trade union. And finally, 189 companies, they actually signed in a legally binding agreement, and its name is Bangladesh Building and Fire Safety Accord. And with the National Garment Workers Federation, we are one of the signatory of this accord. On the other hand, as the president of National Garment Workers Federation, I am actually the steering committee member of the ECHO. So in every places, to make this success of the accord, I am actually trying with my best, and NGWF organizers, they also participating in the factory inspection with the inspection team of the accord, and many of the factories actually did not safe, and we are raising our voice, and to sustain these things, now we are planning how we can set up health safety committee in the factory level, so that at least this safe condition sustain. Up to now, more than 2,000 factory already inspected. From the accord part, the number of inspection factories is 1,186, and some other factories it is inspected by the alliance, and rest of the some factories it is inspected by national NAP, National Action Plan under the Bangladesh government. So in the inspection by that actually run by the accord, almost every places we are trying to involve the workers. And involve of the workers, NGW actually taking the major role. In some of the factories we have the union, we are involving this union in the inspection process. Some of the factories we actually do not have inspection, but factory committees, we are involving this factory committee for the inspection activities. And in others, some factories, though we have not union or factory committee, but we have individual member. Through this individual member, we are also engaging the workers in the inspection process. So up to now, among these 2,000 factories, 29 factories, these were really unsafe. And now these 29 factories, it is permanently or temporarily it is closed down. And obviously the issue was the workers' salary and compensation. The factories, those became closed down. This was the one of the major issue for the NGW, and you will be happy to know that in some way we actually managed so that the workers already got their compensation and back wages from these factories.
Okay.